Hey kids, it's me, Kevin Smith, and I can't thank you enough for making this third trip to the convenience store with me. Thank you. This time's exciting for me because this time everyone finally gets to see Clerks the way I've always seen Clerks. Most people think of Clerks as a black and white movie, and they're right. It was shot in black and white film. But to me, whenever I watch Clerks, even though it's in black and white, the movie appears in color because I lived that life. And so now, thanks to Leron, you're all seeing Quick Stop and the surrounding area, Dante, Randall, Jay and Silent Bob, as I've always seen them from day one, in vivid living color. You know, Quick Stop is the unsung star of all the Clerks movies, if not, you know, the epicenter of the Viewaskew Universe films in general. All stories emanate and flow from that little building. And when I worked there, I hated it. I didn't want to be there. I didn't want to work for somebody else, and I didn't want to work there. And people would come in, and I'd be like, oh, my God, I have to actually wait on people. I just want to watch TV. I didn't even want to work at the convenience store. I tried to get a job at RST Video. There was an ad in the paper for it. I went down, talked to Mr. Topper. He goes, I see you have convenience store experience as well. I said, yeah, I worked in a bunch of convenience stores. And he goes, would you be willing to work in this convenience store next door from time to time? Because we own that as well. And I was like, yeah, if you need help. And famous last words, because it was a convenience store job. He catfished me. I just wound up working at a convenience store with a couple hours in a video store, teased with paradise, then seduced and abandoned to sell goods. So in Clerks, Randall says, man, this job would be great if it wasn't for the fucking customers. But in the script for Clerks 3, I'm going to read you a little something that was there that I didn't use in the movie. During the pullback shot, at the very end, you hear John Corker's Beautiful. I'm from New Jersey. And it was so lovely. I left that moment alone and didn't put in what in the script called for the voice of Smod. That would be me. And this is what you would have heard. Randall Graves spent the rest of his life running Quick Stop groceries whenever he wasn't making movies, with each film financed solely by Crimson Crypto Studios. At a screening of his final film, the Asbury Park Press asked him to sum up a life spent satisfying both the public's demand for cigarettes and soda, as well as their appetite for the many movies he made after his celebrated debut, Clerk. The 90-year-old Randall Graves replied, I always thought the jobs would have been great if it weren't for the fucking customers. But as it turns out, these jobs are great because of the fucking customers. He means it, so do I. Thank you to everybody. Whoever walked through the door of that store and made me think, somebody should put this in a fucking movie. Somebody did. Thank you.